Assalamualaikum. Today I would love to relate my experience from my self composed essay. The title of the essay is An Apology for Etiquette. Etiquette, the meaning of etiquette is the code of polite behavior. So let's see. So I'm requesting all of you to have patience and listen carefully. Etiquette reflects the formal dress of behavior in terms of courtesy, manner, civility, and so on. Such etiquette starts beginning by all individuals since birth. This is the training of mind, body, and soul. It is molded by nature, culture, tradition, norms, values, religion of a particular geographical or political country. Human beings adopt it either spontaneously or by external forces. When people are imperfect towards when people are imperfect without such formal dress of behavior. The first institution of personality development is family and kids, that is child care center. And the first agents are the members of those institutions, like parents. Another universal institution of learning and training is school, which is the institution of mosque, temple, church, because school brings all together at a single platform, regardless of class, creed, color, sex. Learning under the care of nature provides the best learning outcome. Man is the wisest creature, but weakest animal of God. Teacher gets him informed of the way of life. A teacher can be anyone, but nature itself is the greatest teacher. Nature always guides and focuses on fostering creativity rather than on rote memorization. One of the recognized agents of nature is teacher, who is now in our society becoming like a super machine, who is busy remarking what is wrong and right, only instead of guiding. To be the best teacher like nature, a teacher should always remain impartial and humanitarian. If we cut a tree, it stops providing us oxygen, shelter, fruits, etc., but continues to serve us with its disease parts. In school, college, and other educational institutions, many teachers are only busy collecting money and teaching manner, behavior, ethics, and other code of behavior. But the truth is that in many cases, the teachers do not perform all these activities practically. We take some examples. A teacher who gives definition and explanation that qualities of good teacher should be a guide, friend, philosopher, role model, punctual, practical, beneficial, wise, knowledgeable, kind, democratic outlook, moreover, a good human being. It proves absurd if the same teacher fails to possess all these qualities. The real honor of a teacher is determined by the development of character in students. Many teachers discriminate with students in evaluation and other educational progress. Even a small discrimination by a teacher can lead to the end of a student's career. When a teacher creates negative perception of a particular student, that student also makes the same negative perception of that teacher. There are various forms. There are various forms of punishment to the students, like discrimination, biasness, favoritism, and so on. Many a time, a good student of excellent character is developed by those students who approach to their favorite teacher frequently like a psychopath, while others fail to build a healthy relationship with teachers because they believe in their self-potentiality. Every creature of Almighty God makes train in training of their mind, body and soul. And students are not other than a teacher. But the degree of a behavioral mistakes of students should not be given the grade of bad, maladjusted, mental patient, slow learner, slow processor, idiot, incapable. The teacher of every institution should exercise more and more the intuition of positive reinforcement, motivation, love, affection to build harmonious ethics and educate among the students. Thank you.
काम अच्छा करते जाओ, इमेज खराब कोई बात नहीं।
वाह।